Hello everyone, this is a direct message to members of my family. Now, I work as of right now for a company called Vector Marketing. The problem is with this orientation that I'm going through, and one of the biggest problems that I have is basically I have to have people that are within my contact list. The problem with my contact list is that most of my family has their head up in their ass. And what do I mean by that? Back in 1974, I was viciously molested. Now, during the course of the years, there's been a lot of things. Well, one particular incident, and keep in mind, I'm not using names. I could use names in this video, but I'm trying to be respectful. I'm going to give you guys right now to contact me. And what do I mean by that? Well, back in 1974, I was maliciously raped, and my stepkids, brothers, it was their dad who did it. Now, I know a lot of you will be immediately like, what the hell? It really was. It was their dad that committed the crime. Now, over the course of the years, I had a kid. And I will publicly say, I'm not going to say her name out of respect. But what? They started creating these little vicious rumors, quote unquote, saying, I beat my kid. The real truth about what happened to my kid was the fact of the matter is that at the time, there was some stuff that happened. Basically, there was no abuse in the home. But they started creating this rumor saying, well, he was beating his kid. The realization is, it was an infant kid. I held a kid in my arm. I fell asleep. My arms went down. The kid accidentally kicked a chair. Created a little bruise right on the ankle. But the kid did it because it was a baby. It was an infant. Didn't know anything. And the realization is that the Division of Family Services at the time said that there was a beating going on. So they immediately wanted to take the kid out of the home. So I gave my kid to my brother. And my brother raised the kid. But when the kid grew up, they started making this bullshit claim saying I was beating the kid. And they've expelled me for the last 30 years for this crime. And refused to let me see my kid. Refused to let me see the kid. But meanwhile, they kept on running their mouths to people that I knew and started creating this rumor mill out on the deal about how I was neglective, how I was abusive, and everything else. And this is the honest freaking truth. There was no abuse in the home. Number one, I didn't have a job at the time. I was unemployed. And I was living with my stepmother at the time because in that particular incident, which I'm coming clean on, her own brother was abusing her, my wife. And he threatened that he was going to kill the kid. To protect the kid, we decided to move in with my step-parents at the time. And years later, I finally got on my feet. I got a job. I worked 30 years in the newspaper packaging center business. And that is what the whole issue is with them. And in fact, because they didn't want me to be with my wife, and keep in mind, there were some things that happened at one point during our marriage. My wife cheated on me. And when we were first getting ourselves established, first getting in the thing, she asked, I gave her a warning. I said, if you screw around on me one more time, that's it. But they decided to get involved in the situation. And they demanded that I get a divorce. But the problem here is that I want to make this clear is the fact that they had no right to get involved. If I sit there and I tell someone, hey, you know what? Here's the real truth. Then the realization is I would be lying. And once again, I'm going to say something to you. I'm going to say this one more time to you guys. Why are you trying to set the controls and trying to dictate the way I run things? Because you don't have the ability to do that. Let me make something obviously clear to you. And I'm going to give you an opportunity. I'm going to give you an opportunity before we go completely public and I start saying your names. You better pick up that phone right now and you better call me. Because this company, it relies that I use my contact list. Well, in order for me to get my contact list reactivated, I'm going to make this obviously clear because the fact of the matter is, you can't sue me. And I'm going to tell you why you can't sue me. Number one, it's the truth. It is the truth. No matter how many times you try to twist this lie around, it's the truth. Now, I don't care how mad you are, because all you've been acting like by threatening me with lawsuits, not communicating with me, not talking to me, you've been pulling this shit for 30 years. Now, if you don't want this public, you don't want this thing, it's smart that you just pick up the phone and call me because the fact of the matter is maybe, just maybe, I might start naming names. And I could create one of the biggest stink bombs on the internet on something that is within my constitutional rights to do. You've abused me too many times. The only way you're going to shut me up on this incident is the fact of the matter is that you start talking to me. And then when you start talking to me and you start communicating and you get your head out of your ass, that's when this is going to finally go away. Maybe I should pick up a write some books and put it online and do the exact opposite of what you want me to do. Or you get your head out of your ass, you pick up the damn phone, and you call me and you talk to me. Because either way about it, if I don't get my contact list back, people's going to see here something that they ain't going to like about you. So what's it gonna be? Boys, have a nice day.